What is up, guys? Welcome back to Let's Play Phoenix Wright Ace Attorney. With me, Tapis Crazy. Well, let's left off. We did some more investigation. We found out what Gordy really is. And we're also starting to delve into the DL6 incident. And Dates, if you're unsure, let us go into the evidence room or whatever it's called. The place server store historical file, so let's go move in there then. And I've got this thing on the back of my throat, so for some reason it seems like I'm a bit nasally, I don't know why.
December 26, Police Department, Records Room.
Wow! It's amazing! The Dusty!
10 years of files and 10 years of dust, I guess.
Let's find that DL6 stuff quick!
15 years ago. Both me and Edgeworth were 9 years old. We were almost through with fourth grade when he suddenly transferred. Books of DL6?
Nick, I found out where the file is!
Oh, thanks!
Just let me know what you want to know about the DL6 incident! I'll go get the right file!
Okay. The case summary, please. We'll further be able to get a handle on the main facts. Like a summary.
Right! Summary, found it! Here you go!
December 28th, 2001.
That's exactly 15 years ago from the day after tomorrow.
So in 2 days, the case is closed. The incident took place in the elevator of a district court.
What? Is this the same district court we were holding the trial in?
Looks like it.
Shit. This
one. There was a large earthquake at 2 p.m. on that day. Part of a court building collapsed and all the lights went out.
Oh shit. The judge is like, oh shit!
Who screwed up my upstairing gear? I want to rip out the room, not cause an earthquake.
Well, that was some earthquake.
Oh, here we go. That's Edgeworth, if you can tell by the weird hair flick.
At the time, 3 people were trapped in the elevator. It took 5 hours for them to be rescued. 5 hours?
Oh, was that my idea?
That would be scary like that, in the dark.
Oh my Jesus. There was a lack of oxygen in the elevator, and the survivors were unconscious.
The survivors?
One of the 3 in the elevator had been shot. In the heart.
That was Mr. Edgeworth's father, wasn't it?
His evidence father was shot before his very eyes. So Miles Edgeworth was one of the other passengers in the elevator.
Right. Who was the third person then? And why do you get the feeling it's that guy that's in the boathouse?
Do you have data on the victim and his father?
Yeah, hold on.
Victim
here, found it.
Gregory Edgeworth, verified fence attorney. If he's still alive, he'd be 50. He had lost that day's case in court and he got in the elevator with some Miles.
Miles?
Miles Edgeworth, of course.
So he was on the elevator with his father.
Yes, and then he got shot in front of him. That's absolute horseshit.
From the angle of the bullet, another evidence it could not have been a suicide. Murder weapon, a pistol, was found in the elevator. The pistol had been fired 2 times.
2 times.
Where have I heard that before? Sounds just like this current case. What's going on here? Any data I'm suspecting there?
That would be the guy that my mom got arrested. Hold on, this is it! The man
arrested in the suspect is DL6 was Yanni Yogi? He was a clerk in the court, apparently. So he must have been the third person in the elevator.
Well, but he has to have done it!
But he was found innocent, thanks to his defense lawyer, Robert Hammond.
Hammond? The victim in our case!
Right. Oh shit, this is a tangled mess! The suspect, Mr. Yogi, was oxygen deprived, so much so he had brain damage. He lost all memory of being in the elevator.
And who do I know that's acting like he's got brain damage?
After he was declared innocent, he disappeared.
And who do we know that no one knows about his name?
Where could Yogi have gone to, I wonder?
He may be closer than we think.
Yes, exactly.
I guess I know generally what happened in DL6 now. I still don't know what sort of impact the whole thing had on Edgeworth.
Nick! Are we gonna take the whole file? There's too much! We'll never get it out!
You're right. How about we just take what we think we'll need?
DL6 case file added to the court record. Okay.
Right. That's probably all we need to be able to find here. Now all that's left is a trial tomorrow. I wonder how Dad will do testifying in court. Okay.
To be continued.
And I'm not editing any here because I've only started this bloody video, so.
I mean, I should have put that on the end of last video, but who cares?
world a saving.
And we'll just continue on. I shall take a drink of water to clear my throat. Ugh. This case is so long. I mean, it seems like each case is going to double the series, so like... At the end of the first two cases, it was about 10 episodes, and then the next one, and then the third case bumped it up to 19 episodes. So I think by the end of this case, it's going to be about 40 episodes, I think, but we'll find out. I'm not sure how long this is going to be, but if that's the pattern it follows, and there's 77 other things I didn't read.
Shut the fuck up! Court is now in session by the charge of Mr. Miles Edgeworth.
The defense is ready, Your Honor. I am an arrogant bastard, Your Honor. Well, apparently the prosecution is also ready. Who is the judge here, anyway?
Mr. Montcalm, your opening statement. No opening statement, so... Not so fast, Judge. I was taking a meaningful pause before speaking.
Right, of course. A prediction.
Today's trial will end 3 minutes from now. Oh, shit.
Shut up, it has already started with this. Mr. Montcalm, what is the meaning of your statement just now?
Bah! Must you question everything? It will be over in 3 minutes. We have no time to waste. I'll call my witness now.
Right!
I call my witness, my decisive witness, to the stand. The mysterious bookshop owner.
Oh!
Witness, state your profession.
Bah! I'm a proprietor of a restaurant. I'm a wet noodle of God Lake. And I also rent boats.
The night of the instance, you're in the boat rental shop, correct?
Yep, I was.
Please testify. Wait a second. We slamming her from this old guy. Who this old guy is? Raise an objection. Wait a minute. The witness hasn't stated his name yet. Because I did not ask you, Mr. Wright. Bah! I have predicted this trial end in 3 minutes. Stop asking trivia questions and cooperate. Yeah, right.
We need to know his name, though.
The witness will state his name. Bah! I'm not really sure. Yep. What do you mean? My memory?
Your Honor. The witness does not remember anything beyond the last several years. Ergo, he cannot recall his own name.
You can't recall, you say?
Yes, but the incident in question took place 3 days ago. He can testify.
Very well. Let's hear his testimony then, shall we? Witness?
Why is he being vague about his name? I'm not convinced.
It was now the 24th, just after midnight, yeah? I was in the restaurant. Well, where I rent boats, as usual. Then I heard a bang, yep. When I looked out the window, I saw a boat just floating on the lake. Then I heard another bang. Just about then, the boat comes by the shore and a man was by my window. Very well. I'd like to begin cross-examination.
What? No, piss off. There is nothing to question in my witness's testimony. Ergo, no need for cross-examination. Besides, there are only 10 seconds left before our 3 minutes are up. Judge, your verdict now.
Yes, Mr. Wright.
Cross-examine. What are you saying? Of course I'll cross-examine a witness.
Very well, you may begin.
Bah! Oh my God, what's wrong with this guy?
Excuse me, Mr. Von Karma?
3 minutes just passed.
I see. Well, then let's just take our time. You may cross-examine the witness.
What was that?
Why? My intimidation tactics aren't working.
It was 9:24. Look at that.
It was 9:24. Just after midnight, yeah?
Well, it did. Just after midnight, you say?
Yep, just around me.
Are you sure?
Pretty sure, yep.
When I told you the SD, you were rather vague about the time. I suppose you seem so sure about it today. I asked him and he remembered. Isn't that right?
Don't get me like that. I remember it clearly, I did. Yep.
You see, continue.
I was in the restaurant,
What?
A restaurant that rents boats. Is there anyone who can verify that?
Well, I guess Party could.
But that's not good enough for a court of law.
Mr. Wright, exactly what's not good enough?
Your Honor, Miss Polly is a parrot.
A parrot? Terms are out of this girl, Keefy boy.
Keith? The prosecution concedes that we cannot prove a witness was in the shop. Witness, please continue.
Then I heard a bang, yep.
Okay. And where did the bang seem to come from?
Thinking this is a noise.
From the car, figure.
Are you certain?
Yep.
Good, continue.
What a snap of his fingers, though.
When I turned the window, I saw a boat just a flowing on my leg.
Was there someone in the boat?
It was pretty far out there, I couldn't see clearly. But I figured it was 2 men out there, yep.
But you couldn't see them clearly.
Yep, half a time, that is.
Half a time?
Yeah, I don't know what was doing.
Then I heard another bang.
So you heard 2 gunshots total?
Yep.
That's what Lotta said in her testimony yesterday.
Hang on a minute. Two gunshots. And this was fired 3 times, though. So I've had a few opportunities where I could say that a few times, but never anything contradicted. Like they heard another bang, but it doesn't say a number there. So I think that'll come at some point.
Doesn't matter, man. Good man, strong man. What's by my window?
By your window.
Yep, by my window. Right, Sam, window, mind your shit.
Could you see the man's face?
Well, the fog was pretty darn thick, but it's right there in front of me. I saw him. This rather important detail. Please answer your testimony.
Disc.
I have a bad feeling about this.
That man was the defendant. He was saying, I can't believe he's dead.
Okay. Are you sure? Uh-oh. Dad!
Ma! Dead son, Keith. He said, I can't believe he's dead. He was walking by too.
Okay.
Witness, are you sure that the person you saw was Miles Edgeworth?
It was him, Matt Edgeworth, but...
How did he know it was Edgeworth? Oh, he fell over. What clumsy ding-dong.
This sounds like decisive evidence indeed. I see no room for doubt.
Von Karma. He lured me into cross-examining so he could set me up for a fall.
No, I'm not convinced. This.
Nick, I don't like the way things are going here. Everyone in the courtroom is glaring at us.
I better act quick or his trial is going to be over. Raise an objection. Your Honor, we proved in yesterday's court that it could not have been Edgeworth who fired that gun. Mr. Wright, are you referring to the fingerprints from Edgeworth's right hand found on the gun? Of a photograph showing a man firing with his left hand? Exactly. Oh no, that is easily explainable. He could have wiped his prints after he fired. You are ignoring the truth of the matter here. Everything in his witness testimony is true. Patricia's lost in thought, what should I do? There's no objection! Your Honor, this witness claims that Adrian said, I can't believe he's dead. But his word is all we have. If you were telling a lie... Mr. Wright, in the court of law, the evidence tells all. Apparently you have yet to realize even this basic fact. If you say his testimony is a lie, show us proof.
Nick, don't you have evidence?
It's no good. There's nothing I can do.
Are you sure?
To be honest, I don't know what to do anymore.
Please!
I do!
Can you hear me, sis? Please! We need your help! Nick needs you!
This. 3 minutes was perhaps too high an expectation. However, 15 minutes isn't bad. This must be a new record.
Enough! The witness may leave the stand.
He's sleeping on the floor is fine.
This court sees no reason for a prolonged trial. Nor is there any need for more time to decide the case against it.
Come on, bullshit! I could have raised the objection. We don't need bloody Mia.
This case is extremely clear. I see no room for misinterpretation of the facts.
What? No!
This court finds defendant Mr. Miles Edgeworth.
Guilty! Oh.
The accused will surrender to the court immediately, to be held pending trial at High Court within a month from today's date. What is all? The court is adjourned.
Did I lose? What?
What?
Wait, who did that?
Who was that just now? Me!
Huh?
What?
Larry?
Larry! What are you doing here?
Listen, you gotta listen to me.
I was there in the park the night of the murder. I wasn't sure about it until yesterday. But today I remembered it.
Remember what?
A gunshot. I heard it too. Order, shut up, bitches!
What is the meaning of this? The verdict has been decided. I call for adjournment.
One moment, Mr. Malcoma. So we say you heard a gunshot.
Yeah, I did. A gunshot that night. I was sitting here in the audience listening to the testimony. Then I realized something you said was different from what I remember. You know, I can't just sit here and let you call me edgy a murderer. It's just not right. I'll testify. Let me testify.
Okay.
Order, shut up. Well, this is the first time something has happened like this in my court. I rather doubt it, though. I'm not quite sure how to proceed.
Judge, you've already given your decision. The trial is over.
Nick! This is it! Larry's given us one final chance at this!
She's right. Well, it wasn't Larry. You're making things even worse.
Mr. Edgeworth was just declared guilty, Nick. Doesn't get any worse.
You're right. Okay.
Your Honor, if there's another witness, it is our duty to hear him speak. Right here, right now!
A waste of time. The verdict cannot be overturned.
A judge just glares at him like...
Allow me to speak my opinion. Von Carver is a bitch. In all court proceedings, it's our duty to prevent an inaccurate verdict. In order to make sure no mistake has been made, every witness should be heard.
What is this?
I withdraw my previous verdict of guilty. Judge overrules all. Judge doesn't care about rules.
You question me, bitches!
Mr. Volcama, I order you to call this new witness to testify. Now!
What?
Oh, judge has got big balls.
The court will adjourn for a 5-minute recess. After that, we will hear this new witness. Court is adjourned, bitches! Judge makes the rules!
December 27th, 10:28. District Court Development Number 2. Ooh, that was too close. Sorry to keep you on the edge here. See you live at Edgeworth.
I've seen worse.
Yeah, right, Edgeworth. You're sweating bullets. I just wonder what Larry plans to say in there.
Larry was ever late that night.
Yes. He said he went looking for a steel samurai bloom that flew into the lake.
Oh, right.
And he found my balloon in the air tank that night. Yeah. Hey, Edgeworth.
Huh? You say something, right?
Yeah, a lot of things. You seem out of it. What's wrong?
It's nothing.
Mr. Edgeworth, for something I've been meaning to ask you.
What's that?
Why are your fingerprints on the murder weapon?
Oh.
Yeah, you're prosecuting attorney, you ding-dong. Why would you put your fingerprints on evidence?
When he fell into the lake, I went into a daze. I couldn't understand what had happened. I couldn't think straight. Then I saw the pistol lying on the floor of a boat in front of me. I picked it up without thinking. I didn't have a reason, really.
I see.
Right.
Yeah?
This might be our chance.
Our chance?
Volcano's only ever run perfect trials.
Perfect trials?
Perfectly prepared witnesses. Perfectly complete evidence. That's the secret to his success. This is the first time he's ever to deal with something unexpected. He has let someone he hasn't even talked to testify before the court. And that someone is Larry.
What are you getting at?
It's likely his testimony will be full of holes, right?
That's right, Nick. No 10-minute trial this time. We'll make this one for all it's worth.
Hey, it was 15 minutes. 15! Everything depends on Larry now. Oh shit. He's down for the count.
This is like a freaking battle of wits. Jesus Christ.
Judge is back in town! Shut up! Court is now back in session.
Witness! Please testify to the court about everything that you saw on the night of December 24th.
Right, leave it to me.
Please, Larry, don't mess this one up. I hate to admit it, but you're our last chance. We're going to have time to prep his witness. I just made sure if he's right about this being our big break. Everything's a big break.
That night I was out in a boat on the lake. I was looking for something and I found it. So I quietly slipped the boat back into the rental shop dock. Then, just as I was thinking about going home, I heard this bang. I looked out over the lake, but I didn't notice the boat. So after I heard that single gunshot, I went home.
So the first gunshot was known on the lake.
That was an unusually vague testimony, even for this court. In any matter, Mr. Rice, you may begin your cross-examination.
Yes, Your Honor.
What's wrong, Nick?
It's Larry. I have no idea what he's going to say if I press him. I am a little scared.
Well, we've come this far. There's no way to go but forward, Nick.
Okay. We'll just press him on everything, see what details we can get.
But there's a boat on the lake.
What do you mean by lake? What is this?
Something wrong, Mr. Wright?
There are so many things wrong, I don't know where to begin.
Ah.
Well, okay. First off, what time was it?
Well, it was after 11 when I went out in the boat. By that time, everyone had gone home for the night. So I waited until the coast was clear, so to speak.
And why were you out on a boat at such a late hour?
I was looking for something, and I found it.
What was it? Looking for something?
Yeah.
Mr. March, what was it you were looking for?
What the witness was searching for is irrelevant. Most likely he was hunting for his Gordy. You know, it wouldn't surprise me one bit if that was the truth. This is all irrelevant. Let's get it over with.
Okay, I'm surprised he doesn't want to know, to be honest.
What time was that?
Well, let's see. I figure I was out searching for about an hour. I guess it was around 12. Yeah.
You're not sure?
Hey, don't give me that face. I'm not some sort of human sundial, okay?
People use watches these days, Larry. And a sundial wouldn't work at night.
Would a sundial work at night? Just I was thinking about going home, I ripped his bag.
What do you mean by that? Where did the sound come from?
Yeah, well, I wasn't too sure about that. I looked around, you know.
Did you look at the lake?
Yeah, I looked out over the lake, but I didn't notice the boat.
Wasn't there a boat on the lake?
Shut up! Order! Well, Mr. Butch?
Whoa. Everybody just calm down, okay? I mean, it was real foggy that night. I'm not sure whether there was a boat out there or not.
Oh, okay, no problem. That's just the most important part of his case.
I went home.
What do you mean by that? So, you only heard one bang, correct?
Yeah. Oh, Nick!
It was a pretty wishy-washy testimony, wasn't it? Is there just start working on the contradictions?
Sorry, I wish I could be more helpful. Wish I could call my sister.
Ring, ring, bitch.
Let's have a look at what evidence I've got. 11:50. That's fine. Some of this, isn't it? We need a lot of disposition.
Objection, bitch! Blah, blah, blah,
blah. Wait a second, Larry.
What?
You only had one bang. You're sure?
That's what I said.
But Miss Lothar testified as if it showed two bangs. And the old man just now said the same thing. They both heard two gunshots that night.
Huh?
Were you even listening? Were you paying attention at all to what they said?
Yo, Nick, please.
Huh?
You know something's been bothering me. I'm a witness, see? I'm like a customer here. So you gotta treat me nice and stuff, okay?
Mr. Butch!
What?
You only heard one gunshot, I assure.
Well, to tell you the truth, I'm not sure.
Huh?
Not sure? How can you not be sure?
Yeah, well, I might have missed the other gunshot. I was listening to something else.
Something else?
My radio, dude, on my headphones.
What?
Brah, 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 brah. Was listening to shitty tunes. Stop that booing! Mr. Butch, you're listening to a radio on earphones?
Yeah, so what? That a crime? I listen to my radio. Everyone listens to radio. What's the big deal?
Mr. Montgomery, your opinion?
Waste of time. I do not accept his witness nor his shoddy testimony.
Well, Mr. Wright, should he continue with testimony?
Continue. Your Honor, please, please allow us to continue his testimony. Bah! Nothing is more pitiful than a lawyer who doesn't know and he's lost.
Very well, Mr. Butch. Please give your testimony and be sure to include details like your radio!
Right, leave it to me!
I wouldn't if there were any other way out of this. Believe me.
Right, okay, and we'll do this testimony in the next episode because I'm out of time this one, so... Thanks so much for this, guys. I hope you enjoyed it. Remember to like, subscribe, and I'll see you all
in the next video.